This was me inside a bus, and this man was resting his leg on mine. I had to tell this man to move his leg. You should stop resting his leg on my leg. The man sat down like it was a sitting room. I was so pissed. The annoying thing this man came and told me is that I'm the one resting my leg on his and I should not disturb his morning prayers. You can imagine. Some people are not Christians. They're only after themselves. How you doing? I hope you're good. I hope you enjoyed the last clips you've been seeing before this. So I wanted to make this video at home, but I was waiting late for work. I said to just do it now. I don't know if you can hear me. Fan is quiet. Okay, I just assume you can hear me. So I want to tell you my experience of how it's been robbed some years ago in my apartment. Yep. So this peaceful night at about 3 a.m. in the morning, you know, when everyone is peaceful, you tend to know how peaceful an environment is. But that day came, I felt this disturbing movement that was happening, and I had to listen for a while. I heard some people shouting. I thought like normal, you know, shout, because in those days that's what people do. Don't expect calmness every time, do you get? But this sound was somehow, it was suspicious. That was how I thought to myself that this is robbery. Immediately I stood up, wore my jean trousers, put on my shirt, and a big shirt. And mind you, before that day, before that event, at about 10 p.m. at night, my husband then, before we got married, called me and told me, "Hope you are not sleeping naked." I'm like, "Okay, what's your business? Do you understand? What's your business?" And like, "If you are, go and put on clothes." I don't know, maybe God used him to talk to me that day, but mind you, I did not listen. So when that thing happened, I just remembered what he said. I quickly went to put on my jean trousers and a shirt. That was how I got ready. Then that time I had a phone and a tab. I had to move the SIM, the battery, so in case maybe I turn it off and it comes on when they enter. I cannot do anything, you know? So I had to hide it inside my box, my very big box. Then the tab, I removed the SIM, my memory card that was there, and hid it, then put it on the table. Because I remember when I was little, my father used to keep some money separately in the house. When he comes back from shop, he keeps money separately. I remember when I was little, I asked him, "Daddy, why used to put money in this place and you don't touch it?" My father said, because when robbers come, you must have something to give to them. So when they come, if at all they come, this is what I have for them. Do you understand? Then he told me that. So I remember that word my father told me at that time. And that was the reason why I could leave that town. You just imagine, you just come and say you don't have a phone. Somehow, did you get? There's no light to justify it. And we're going from rooms to rooms to rob. You know that moment, and you're waiting for your own turn for you to be robbed. That was me at that moment. That was me that very night, because it was still dark. It's night, early morning. And then my heart was racing. Just now smiling. If at that time I'm narrating the story, I wouldn't be smiling. Just telling me how God works in ways you don't expect. It got to my own door. They kept on hitting the door, and the door refused to open. Mind you, it's a wooden door. I'm like, hit this door 3-4 times. Should have made this door open. That shows that God was actually by my side at that door. And the thing I heard was, open this door unless you want us to shoot. I heard shoot. Like, and mind you, before that, when the guy hit the door like 2 times, somebody out there was saying, let's leave this girl, she's a good girl, this and that. Like, that means they must know me for this person to say this. And the person was cajoling them to just leave my door and go to the next door. But they said no. I went and opened the door myself. I went and sat on the bed. I was looking at them. Next thing, they beat me because they said I took time to come and open the door. My door stressed them, so they beat me so bad. Well, that was my concern at that moment. And then another person was like, she don't come on SIM card and memory card. She's a smart girl. Yes, they slapped me. That one is fine, no problem. What that pain me most is the bed sheets that I just washed, that they use sand and their boots to mess up. Ha! It was killing me. Then the bad part was when one of them was trying to pull my shirt. You know the kind of thing, they're trying to pull my shirt. And next thing I did, I said, call the name of God. Fine, there are God and there are God. I have to specify, specific on the God I'm calling. Just kept on saying Jehovah. Do you understand? Like, that name is higher than all other names. It's not just God. His name is Jehovah. So I kept on calling that name. And he was like, one of them was like, stop calling that name. And that was the other one in the background, which I do not know. I can't even try and get the voice. But the person to like say that, obviously the person knows me. That was saying, where would they go? And that was how it left. Now the thing was in my head that if they have to come back, because there's still some time, they might want to, you know, take advantage of me girls. I just went on my knees and prayed. Yes, I went on my knees and prayed to God. I went to close my door. I realized that my door was barred. It was not even closing. I ran to my bathroom and stayed. And before I knew it, after I robbed, I started hearing girls crying. I was praying so bad. At the end, I did not hear anything. They left. That was my experience with robbers the first time where I was living. It was so traumatic for me because I found it hard to sleep at night for 3 months until I had to leave Benin and go to stay in Lagos. It was so traumatic for me at that point in time. Yes. I just pray you guys are hearing me. I don't wish that for anyone. Any form of robbery. I actually don't feel anyone should experience it. It's not a good experience, let me be honest with you. It's not a good experience. So, the funny part was when police came, it's like they were still feeling sleepy. one of them's moms like fell. Like, this is the person that wants to come and protect your team at all even here. But anyways, we thank God. Thank God for it and for that. And I'm happy to be sharing the story with you. That was the first hobby I had. I don't know. Maybe I will tell you the second one I also experienced. It's not a small thing actually. It's not small. But anyways, if you like this video, if you like what I put up there, if you like my videos, share, subscribe to my channel.
Watermelon.